Hi, everybody.
Hey, so we did Hollow Scream last week. It was amazing. We got invited, we got to go and kind of get in a little bit early and see some of the things, and so we wanted to be here so that we could tell you guys a little bit about it, so you could see an interview with one of the creators, and you can tell them a little bit more about that, I suppose.
Yeah, it was super fun. We are so grateful, very, very grateful to Busch Gardens to invite us out, to represent all of the Indigo Chameleon Nights out there, and to share our kind of cool like experience about, they did, we're now a stranger to haunts, like going to different haunts and haunted houses and stuff like that. But this was cool because the whole experience took place outdoors, and we'll talk a little bit more about that, I guess, as things go on. But all of the scare, it was just like a bunch of like cool like scare zones, each like hyper themed.
Yeah, everything was outdoors. It was great. Oh, hey, Dice Barbarian! Yay! So anyway, we're gonna go ahead and kick it off with the interview that Scribe did. And we're gonna go to that, and then we'll come back and we'll tell you a little bit about kind of what we thought and kind of our review of the event. And then we've got some video footage to show you as well.
You're about to watch me fangirl out.
Yay, here we go.
Hey!
Hello there, John. What's going on, buddy? How are you? I'm good. I'm very good. Hi, everybody. It's your good buddy, Scribe. I'm having the absolute pleasure, and I'm trying not to nerd out completely right now while I talk to you, while I talk to John Prost, the Hollow Scream show manager this year. This is a complete honor, sir. So thank you.
I'm super excited.
Yeah, all of our viewers are too. So we're with the Indigo Chameleon Network, and when I went to our audience and I told them I was going to sit down with you, the first and foremost thing that they wanted me to communicate is thank you. A big slobbery thank you for keeping the haunts alive in Central Florida. Dude, thank you. Like it's the Halloween season. We need our spooky time. We need as much distraction as we can get. So honestly, heartfelt thank you from all of our viewers, all the subscribers for doing what you do.
That's not lost on our team at all. In fact, you know, when we were making those decisions, you know, to make sure that the event is safe itself is, you know, knowing that we have our guests and our fans and our performers themselves really look forward to this event every year. So we're just as excited to be back as y'all are excited to be here with us.
Okay, so let me kick this off, okay? Because I read an interview that you did a while ago with the International Association of Amusement Parks and Attractions, and something you said stood out to me. You said, don't be afraid to try something different. We're living in different times right now. So tell me what Hollow Scream is doing differently this year. How are we where the puck is headed with this haunt season?
Yeah, absolutely. And you know what we normally do is we plan Hollow Scream a year in advance. So obviously, yeah, it's a new departure for us. You know, we usually start Hollow Scream when we open the year prior. So we were planning on a different approach than what we're going with this year. And when everything came with COVID, we knew that we had to take a departure to ensure that the event was going to be safe. So it really took a lot of kind of seeing what we can do great for the event. What do we do best at Hollow Scream? And that's different than what we're used to. We're going to have to get creative with it. And it's bringing the scares to the streets. That's something we're wonderful at doing because there's nowhere to hide. There's 335 acres of play area for our scare actors. So that's what we felt we could do is we had to get creative to bring a wonderful event for our guests.
I mean, let's be honest here. I'm a former scare actor, okay? Like, I put my time in. You always wanted to be on the streets because they couldn't hide. Like, people couldn't hide. The best scares came from the streets. It's that open air. Like, it was that nice, cool weather, hopefully. So are the actors thrilled to be able to try something new as well?
You know, the response that we've gotten from our performers has been overwhelmingly positive. It's absolutely wonderful to see the response that we've got. We're already in the middle of rehearsals and training and everything like that. And we've been really clear. We know it's a different year for Hollow Scream. And I think what I always tell our team and what everyone really knows is the creativity, the energy, the passion that our performers have for the event and the impact that they have on the guests is what sets Hollow Scream apart from any other event out there. And I told them that if there's any team that can have the creativity to take those curveballs and give that guest experience, it's going to be our team out there. So they've got that energy, they've got that excitement, and they're ready to put one heck of an event on for 2020.
That is epic. Were there any challenges in casting this year? Like, I know that there's got to be so many people anxious and ready to jump into it. Were there challenges on your part, like sort of knowing or planning for these street housings, or like, what were your challenges from a casting perspective?
Yeah, so we had a couple different approaches that we had to consider for casting. Is first was our normal audition process. Normally, we bring everyone on property. We have a big, large-scale audition process. And, you know, that's always a lot of fun, especially those that are returning scare actors. Really enjoy that process. That's really one of the big things that they enjoy for it. But what we also had to do is we had to evaluate every single role that's part of the event. And, you know, the proximity to guests, the proximity to themselves. We had to evaluate every single role of the event to make sure that it was done properly, but it was also safe for everyone involved.
Yeah, absolutely. And then that's tantamount. It seems like Hollow Scream, Busch Gardens, all of the creative team that's involved is doing what they can to make sure that it's a safe environment for the guests coming, and not only the guests coming, but you're looking out for the actors, which is hugely important. And everybody that works there, it's equal parts. And I think that's what gets me excited and kind of hyped to come and experience it, because I remember being that guy. I remember being the guy and having the, like, I'm not going to brag, but I am going to brag. I was a slider back in a little bit of my thinner days, and bringing the sparks up on the ground. And like, so I get it. I've been there. So thank you for looking out for them too.
And they're the ones that put on the event. So, you know, I always, you know, when y'all talk to us, the biggest thing I always remind everyone is that it's our performers that make the event come to life. So that's what we always like to reiterate to our team, is it's them that make this event what it is.
Can we talk a little bit about the scare zones? Can we talk about, like, you got some fan favorites coming back. I went to Deadly Toys. I remember vaguely because my eyes may have been closed. I think it was about allergies, like, and my wife was the one pushing me through that section. So that's a little intense. But you've also got some new stuff. Can I ask what you're, like, most excited about? I know you're going to say, like, probably everything, but what is the one that you're stoked for people to see? Is there one in particular?
Great. What I'm stoked for everyone to see is actually where I'm at right now. I'm coming to you from the junkyard. This is one of our new open air scare zones. So see, we're in the middle of this crazy torn down junkyard in the middle of Busch Gardens. However, what's really cool about this, beyond the scares, beyond the haunts that are involved in this, you're going to see some Easter eggs of Hollow Scream Pass. So you're going to see some stuff from previous haunted houses. You're going to see some stuff from previous scare zones. So not just for those that are ready to get a scare and a haunt, but those that are diehard fans like yourself and a lot of your viewers, they're going to see stuff that they recognize. I mean, you might even see Fluffy from Zombie Mortuary, if you remember Fluffy, one of my favorites, you might see back out here. So you'll see some of those Easter eggs. That's really what I'm kind of excited about.
No, John, it's just you and me. Forget about the cameras for a second. Forget about this menacing figure kind of walking behind you a little bit.
What are you talking about?
I'm alone. You're alone here? Okay, good. Hit me with that Easter egg. Hit me with that one little thing that you can share, that I can share with Indigo Chameleon. Something for them to look out for. It's just you and me, John. Like, what is that little thing to look out for?
I'd say keep your eyes on the end of Junker. That's all I'm going to tell you. Keep your eyes on the end. I'm not going to give it all away. I'll get yelled at, trust me. But I
don't get yelled at.
Do not close your eyes towards the end.
Okay. No, I'm about this. One of the other ones that I'm looking forward to is the first fear, where you have all of these. Busch Gardens is so good, and Hollow Scream is so good about paying attention to the past, like not ignoring it and moving on to the future, but also like acknowledging the legacy of Hollow Scream. You've always been so good about that. And I'm excited. I'm already starting to gear up for Saturday for the little nuances that I can spot along the way, and that hopefully our viewers that are going to be watching along can spot along the way. So thank you. This makes my heart very happy. Anything else that you... Yes. Anything else you want to share with them? Any parting words for your Hollow Scream experience?
Yeah, before you come out, make sure you do make a reservation. Go to howlofscream.com. Very important. It's a limited capacity event. So we want to make sure you can get those reservations because they will sell out quickly. Also, I forgot to tell you that Fiends is back. Did you know that? Fiends is back. So it's not going to be at Stanleyville Theater this year. It's going to be an open-air experience like we're giving you with the Scare Zones. So it's going to be
Whoa.
And of course, it's a quarantine theme. So
I'm looking forward to the jokes already. For whatever's going to be touched upon in the Fiends show, I'm excited. I'm excited for do we still have like food vendors and stuff like that too? Are we extending that this year as well?
About Howl & Scream, it's actually going on in the middle of Beer Fest. So during Howl & Scream, you get a chance to taste a little bit of Beer Fest that's going to be going on. So those locations will be open to kind of mix it up a little bit. So you won't just have our traditional vendors that we have out there. You'll still have a lot of great, wonderful food options throughout the event, but it's also an extension to get you a little taste of Beer Fest.
John, you had me at Beer Fest. Thank you. Thank you so much for taking some time today. Good luck with rehearsals. Good luck with gearing up for that final push. You know that a lot of Indigo Chameleonites are going to be there, and I look forward to possibly running into some folks on Saturday night when we walk the streets, and I definitely don't close my eyes.
Good. And I hope to see you out there.
But we'll be there. Thanks again.
Thank you.
And it's forever. He had you appear. Yes, he did have me appear. I'm so glad that all of you could sit and enjoy me being awkward and fangirling a tiny little bit. That was the cool little interview that we were able to do and kind of share with Indigo Chameleon. And thank you for everybody that submitted questions on the Discord. That helped us so much to kind of give me a path to choose and a path to kind of like steer my questions. So thank you for that.
As far as general reviews, I think the biggest thing that people are asking is it worth the money? And I say absolutely yes, but the disclaimer here is take advantage of the time. If you're just going to just see the scare zones, you're going to be done really fast and you're probably going to feel like, oh gosh, wow, I finished, like, especially if you go early, like I recommend.
Yeah.
You're going to probably be done with most of the scare zones in about an hour and a half. So to get that extra kind of bang for your buck, plan on going on the rides, plan on doing the scare zone stuff early and then going on the rides because the park gets fairly empty, and you can go through and get on a lot of those rides with very, very little wait. And it's really fun to get to do those rides at night. So that's kind of my biggest recommendation. My other big recommendation that I have is, depending on how you feel personally about masks and masking, if you are more mask-oriented, I know we tend to be a little bit more mask-oriented in public, what you will find is different people have different feelings on that, and it worked out really, really well for us to go early and see those scare zones first thing, because it's Busch Gardens, and there's beer, and there's wine, and there's all sorts of things, and the more people start to drink, the less people start to be attentive to masks, and so you're going to find that people are going to be better about social distancing, they're going to be better about the masks and that sort of thing a little earlier in the evening. The employees are doing a really good job trying to help to maintain that, but they can only do so much. So if that's something that's really important to you, I would definitely recommend doing those portions of things as early as possible. Same with the show, seeing the first show. They do have indicators on the benches as to where you're supposed to be and so that you can stay socially distanced, but not everyone is super cognizant of understanding how that's working. And so it just kind of takes patience and it takes being there a little bit early and making sure that you're in a place that you are comfortable being in.
Busch Gardens has done everything that they can. A lot of there's a couple of the scare zones that require you to wait in a bit of a queue. The longest I think we waited all night was for the shortcut, the one that takes you through the graveyard.
And it was less than 10 minutes.
And it was less than 10 minutes. But there's clear markings. I mean, when you're going into the park, there's clear like tape markings and things of that sort. But Indigo's right. I mean, the more you drink, you know, the more crowded the park gets, the less people are about social distancing and things of that sort. But overall, we had a great time. It was great to be able to go out and see the park. And I can't remember the last time I was at Busch Gardens. So just being able to explore and like see the animals were still chittering away. Like there was really cool to kind of walk from scare zone to scare zone. Did you have a favorite scare?
I did. Ooh, we should talk about this afterwards because that way people can see what it was.
Oh, sure, yeah.
Actually, we don't. I have a favorite scare, but it's actually not on the video, so I'll tell you about it afterwards. The other thing you're going to see on the video is we got the little the Beer Fest cards.
Ooh, lanyards.
And if you go early enough to be able to use those, that was a lot of fun. It's very akin to like Food and Wine at Epcot, that sort of thing, where they've got little booths and you can go and you can get little plates of food. The lanyards are nice because most of the food ranges in price from about $6.99 to about $10.99 per dish. I would say on average it's about $8 or $9 for a dish or a beer or whatever it is. So with the cards, you can get them in different increments, but we calculated out that like the 12 item card, it works out to $5 per item, so you save a lot of money. And pass holders can get it like a 15 card item for the exact same price that everybody else gets them for 12. So it's worth it if you're planning on getting a lot of different food items to sample. But check the times. We had not checked the times on the Beer Fest because it ends at a certain point before the event starts. So you want to kind of get in all of those snacks beforehand while that card is still good. And then they do open up some booths later, but we weren't able to get really, really clear on answers on exactly what booths were opening and when and what they were going to be serving. So if you want something a little bit more predictable that's on the menus, go early.
Yes, what she said. There's a lot of cool stuff, and it has a kind of a pop-up vibe as you get later on into the night. Some of the food booths that may not have been open right when you came in may have opened by then, and then there's all these little, like, places. So Busch Gardens is made to explore. Hollow Scream fits that same theme. You're made to explore and walk around the park and find stuff, but that lanyard, it is worth the money. We cannot recommend it enough. Go get it. So
we're going to share some of the video footage that we took. Some of this went up on our Facebook. So if you're on our Facebook, you may have seen a little bit of it. And we'll see you at the end of that footage. Hi there. How are you?
It's Indigo Chameleon and your good buddy Scribe. We are reporting live from Hollow Scream, Busch Gardens, Tampa.
It's true. And we have food. Oh my gosh. We've actually eaten some of it. We were going to show it to you and then we were really hungry and so we started eating it. But, what was it? What were the different foods that we got? Because we got this cool little lanyard.
So right now, Hollow Scream is doing Beer Fest. And Beer Fest is this like almost like their take on like the food around the world.
Yeah, like the food and wine kind of thing. But there's like, there's beer, there's wine, there's, I've seen other things that weren't beer or wine, but I can't remember what they are right now. We have beer. And we got this cool little lanyard thingy, and they have them for like 5 different items or 8 different items or 12 different items. And if you're a pass holder, you can get one with 15 items. And so you just like buy the little lanyard and then you get to pick out what you want from each of the booths. And it's kind of already done and paid for and stuff.
But big thank you to Busch Gardens for bringing out Indigo Chameleon tonight and giving us tickets. We're super excited. Hey, David, welcome. We're at Busch Gardens in Tampa. They're doing Hollow Scream.
And it's all outdoors. They've got there's a stage behind us. You can't really, here, I'll kind of turn this around so you can see it. No, I can't. Okay. There's a stage behind us. They've got kind of an outdoor show that's at 8:30 and then another time tonight. And then everything else, all the scare zones, everything is outside. Everybody's in masks. We are not right now because we are at our own little private table with like beer and food. And we had these like taco drunken shrimp things that were really, really good. And we were told that the bison slider is absolutely not to miss. So we have it. Ooh, we have it and we haven't even eaten it yet because we were saving it for last.
Right now there's just one beer in us. Like we're working on our first beer.
You're further ahead than me.
I made friends with the guy that was pouring the beer, and so he gave us a large size for free, which is great.
Well, technically not, because it was with our lanyard.
We got an upgrade. So, we're going to be reporting here throughout the night. We'll take some videos. We'll go through the scare zones for those of you that don't live in Florida or want to experience it.
Hello, Ophelia!
Fancy Bill! Ophelia! Yay. Hello. To everybody that's hanging out tonight, if you want to live vicariously through Indigo, hey, Ophelia, don't tell us what to do. I mean, we're going to have fun.
We love you. We're excited. We got to kind of preview a scare zone as we walked through over the Beer Fest. There weren't any of the scare actors at or anything yet, but we kind of got to see it
It's looking really neat. I'm really excited. And also, there's kind of a mystery element because there are no maps. All the maps here, because of all the COVID stuff, you take a photo of the map. You can't carry around a paper map. But the scare zones are not on the regular map. So we feel like this is kind of a...
We missed you too, Fancy Bill.
Exploration kind of thing, where we just kind of stumble into scare zones. So there's something kind of exciting about that.
Yeah, absolutely. So, it's kind of a get lost.
Yeah.
Get lost. Aisle.
Yeah, get lost. Yep. I mean, don't get lost, because something might be scary.
I did get a glow-in-the-dark hat.
And then you'll be scared. He did. You can't see, but it, like, flashes and stuff. He's flashy. Mm-hmm. Anyway, so we will check in later, especially when things get dark and spooky and scary and stuff like that. And right now, we're going to finish our beers and eat this bison slider. So,
but we
you
love
guys
you
have fun.
Very much. Aw, Ophelia, I love you.
All right, welcome to Hell on Wheels. Oh my goodness, we've got bikes. We've got like people in the background here. I don't know if you can even hear me because of the mask, but the stone walker over here is amazing. Yeah, hang on a minute. Put up the sign there. It's right here. I'm super excited about this one. So we just walked through a scare zone that we couldn't really show you because it's hard to appreciate on camera because it's just, I don't even know what it was called, but it was just a whole bunch of people in like...
ghillie suits.
Yeah, and they were hidden everywhere and it was so startling and it was really, really, really good, but it's really, really hard to predict where they're gonna be, so it's hard to stream, but we're gonna show you this one. This is Little Nightmares, and we're gonna turn the camera around so you can see it. All right. Candy! Oh my gosh, I love the use of the bungees here. This is like the second place we've seen them have the bungees incorporated, which has been really neat.
There's some very unique opportunities here, even maintaining social distancing, even maintaining the space apart. I'm really impressed with what Busch Gardens has been able to accomplish. So,
okay, we'll check in a little later. Zones. I love it so much. Central Florida actor actors back on stage. Everybody was in masks the whole time. Incredible dancing, incredible energy. Their leads, Igor and Dr. Frankenstein, like...
Dr. Frankenstein.
I'm sorry. They gave it like 150% up there. It was like, it was so much fun. It was weird and it was a lot of dancing, but like a lot of fun.
It was good to have the haunt season back in full swing, kids. We'll do a full review and we'll release some of the footage that we took that didn't make it to live. But just know that we love you, for everybody that was hanging out with us and watching the little individual Facebook Lives. We love you very much. We'll see you soon.
Indigo Connect!
Indigo Connect. Hard hands?
Hard hands. Here we go. There we go. Good night! Hey! So what was your favorite scare zone of the night?
Are we not going to talk about that awkward heart hands?
That was so awkward. It was terrible.
My favorite scare zone of the night. There was a couple of good ones. I kind of like Lycan Landing. I know Lycan Landing, like, I just like the little trailers and the whole story of the wolves attacking the park, and they had these little, like, tents and sleeping bags, and, like, occasionally they had all these, like, little, like, tractor trailers and stuff like that, and they would light up with scenes inside the tractor trailer and then go dark, and then they'd reenact the scene, and it was just a cool premise.
And the trucks kind of lighting up and the headlights and stuff like that was startling.
I think I know this answer. What was your favorite scare zone?
Okay, so my favorite scare zone you didn't get to see. I kind of referenced it a little bit on the video. And I wish that they'd had these guys everywhere. And it was the most underrated. I don't think it was even considered a scare zone. It was like the most underrated area. But they had all these people in like ghillie suits, like the plant, like they're all covered in plants and stuff. And then they were hidden in the bushes, and so some people would just like shake the bushes as you went by, and or make like little like tick 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 kind of noises, and you know all this stuff. So, but you never knew quite where it was happening. So you'd just be walking through kind of the darker areas with just the shrubs and things, and all of a sudden you'd have all these little noises and plants moving. And I wish that they had them in every single scare zone. It was really cool. It was really unique and a lot of fun.
A testament to a good scare zone is if there's a scare zone where you would just hang out and watch people get scared, and that was the ghillie suits area. That was the area where everybody's just hanging on the plants, and you and I take our time walking that area because we were just seeing people get frightened and jumped out. It was great. It was great.
And if any of the people that are in those scare zones end up watching this video, like, more credit to you. I've been in scare zones before. I've been a part of events from a performer's perspective, and there's always that group who kind of gets forgotten about a little bit because they're not like the big headliner group. You guys were amazing. This group was amazing.
Tell you what, awkward heart hands just
awkward
for you.
Heart hands just for
just for you.
Just for
you. Ghillie suitors.
That is so awkward. Yep. But we love you, ghillie suitors. You were amazing.
Yeah. It was a good time.
We did. We had a blast. We got to see pretty much everything and
Fiends, all the flip flips.
We got to see pretty much everything. I thought we'd gotten to see everything. There was only one thing we missed. And we walked out, and I thought we'd seen everything. We kind of have to go back, I feel like, at some point, because there's only one scare zone. What scare zone did we accidentally miss that I didn't realize we'd missed? What one was it? What did it have in it? I can't remember. What was that? What was the featured?
The clowns at the Midway.
Oh, got it. Yeah, that was the one that we just completely, I don't know, just somehow bypassed.
We skipped the clowns at the Midway.
I wasn't upset about it at all.
Well, that's all the time we have.
Anyway. we had a blast. If you go, let us know how it was, how you liked it. And find us on Twitch, right here on YouTube.
All that fun stuff. We love you guys. Yes. Indigo Connect, and we'll see you very soon.
Not awkward heart hands.
Mine are still always kind of awkward. Bye.